We've got an example of a box on a raised platform off the floor. This point from where the box is to where this offset that we're going to create, it's going to jump off the main floor onto this higher level. How we measure for that, take our tape measure, we measure from the box where we want to end up at to where the obstruction starts. And this one shows that the obstruction starts right around 21 3/4 of an inch. The height of this offset is going to be 2 1/2 inches. That's going to get us from this plane to the floor. Now, one thing we got to think about is how are we going to strap this? We're going to use a mini, we're going to use a one hole. On this example, we're going to use a mini. What the mini does is get us in the same height as our connector is from the plane to where the bottom of the connector is. This is the same height. So we're not going to worry about a small box offset here. All we're going to worry about is an offset to get from this plane to this plane. How we measure that and what we do with this, we said 21 3/4, and it's going to be 2 1/2 inches. Now, we have these little cards. It has a cheat notes on it. Now, for 2 1/2 inches, I'm going to go with a 30-degree offset. That's a little rough, but that's what we're going to go with. For a 30-degree offset, our multiplier is on this card, and it tells us our multiplier is two times. If we're dealing with 2 1/2 inches over here, our multiplier is going to be 2 times 2 1/2 inches. 2 times 2 1/2 inches, of course, will be 5 inches. So from our point A that we're going to mark on our straight conduit to our point B, which we'll mark on the conduit, there'll be 5 inches between those. But where do we start? We're going to start at our physical dimensions here at 21 3/4. So we take our straight piece of pipe. We're going to measure from the end 21 3/4. We'll take our pencil. A lot of people want to use a Sharpie, a marker. Never use a Sharpie or marker on conduit because that will bleed through any paint selection that's happening. So 21 3/4. We're going to make that mark all the way around the conduit, all the way around. And then, as I said, we're going to use that 30-degree angle. We're going to multiply that rise at 2 1/2 times 2, and that's going to be 5 inches. So then we take 5 inches from mark A to mark B. Again, we mark that all the way around the conduit. Now we got mark A, mark B. The thing about this is we have an orientation. We measured this way. Our hook on our tape measure is here. That means our hook on our bender is going to be the same orientation. If you turn the bender around, you'll get the wrong bend. Now we've got our marks that we designated. We got mark A, mark B, and again, we measured them with our tape measure pointing that direction. So the hook on our bender is going to point that direction. We've got all the marks on our bender for the different degrees. We're going to put this first bend, this first mark, right at the arrow. And we're going to put that on the floor, stand beside it. If you're left-handed, you'll be on the other side. But you're going to put foot pressure on this, and you're going to go up to 30 degrees. Now, 30 degrees, there's tick marks on the bender, mainly foot pressure, a little bit of arm pressure, but mainly foot pressure. Once you get close, you're going to take a level and check and make sure you actually are. This is a nice level here. It's got the 30-degree mark on it. We're going to see how close we are. It looks like we need a little bit more. Pull it just a little bit more until the bubble goes in between the lines and stays there. Okay? And we got 30 degrees on that first bend. Now, to make the second bend, what's got to happen is you actually have to pick the conduit up with the bender and stage it overhead. Okay, now we've got the first bend complete, we know it's 30 degrees. We're going to take this, we're going to stand it up like this. We're going to put a little back pressure, lift up, slide that conduit forward, spin it around 180 degrees, and line up mark B on the arrow. Okay? Here's where the line of sight and your visual preference has to be in line. I can use this bender handle and a straightforward look and try to make sure everything's in alignment so that it's straight as I put the second bend in. Okay? Line it up. Now what I tell people to do is put your foot in front of the bottom of this bender. Put your knee behind the backside. Take your hand, put a lot of pressure right here. Push down, kind of lean forward. Use your shin and make that second bend. Now, because we got so much protruding forward, it's hard to spin this around, put it back on the floor and finish the bend. So this one, I'm going to finish the bend completely overhead. This is where you have to line up the tick marks on the side, kind of do a visual to make sure it's all lined up. And this comes over time with skill to kind of look at it and make sure it looks right to you. It looks to me like this one's just over bent just a little bit, and that's okay because we can take it, roll it around. Before I can confirm this over bent, we'll put it on the ground, we'll do a level and see if it's straight. We'll take a tape measure and see if it's the 2.5 inches that we're looking for. If not, we'll take a little bit out. So is that level? Our level mark looks like it's just a little bit high. We'll use a tape measure and see if we're 2.5 inches. We're a little bit high, right? So what happens is that second bend, I know it's got a little bit more in it than it needs to. Being this is 3/4 inch EMT, I can put my foot on it and just kind of push down a little bit and take some of that out. Get it down to the 2.5 inch, which is where we want. We check the level. Getting closer. Push a little bit more on it, and it's pretty close, right? We're looking for 2.5 inches of raise. We've got it, we're level, and now let's see if it fits what we was trying for. Our whole goal was for this to slide right into that connector, raise off this plane, onto this plane, and fit, and this first mark be in line with it, and we're perfect.